Hello Aries, welcome back to my channel. This is a weekly horoscope for you and a tarot reading. Okay, this week we are going to focus on only the planetary transits are very very low this week, and we are not going to have much of any turbulent or chaotic things. But still, this week is little bit potential because on June 11th, the Mars has already entered into Leo. Okay, so we'll be feeling little bit enthusiastic, argumentative, active, and maybe after a long pause, maybe now you'd have started working or thinking about traveling, commuting, and all those stuffs can happen. And it's in your fifth house, okay? Mars entering into your fifth house could be about feeling like you want to date again, or some romance can enter into your life. You could have some new enthusiasm for creative projects, okay? Using your creativity, writing, drawing, painting, listening, or dancing, or even singing, whatever is your creativity. You will be having some energy to express it openly right now. And then we have one important thing, that is this 2021, we are going to have Saturn and Uranus squaring three times this year, okay? When major planets square, what happens is you'll be getting energies where you'll be feeling like as if whatever you want to do or whatever you're passionate about, it gets jolted down with energies that hinder your progress or make you feel that you are a little bit not ready or up to par for it, okay? So Saturn is actually squaring Uranus can cause breakups, arguments, and also some kind of energy where you want to do something but the other people will not be on board to do it, okay? And specifically that's happening on June 14th. So the Valentine's Day that happened on February 14th, February 17th to be precise, Feb 17th Saturn squared Uranus, okay? And again in December 24th I think it was squared. So what is the issue here is that if you had some arguments with a particular person or people during this Valentine's Day or during that Valentine's Day time, like February 14th to 17th, those issues can again come up right now. Okay, right now, especially when the Saturn again squares Uranus on June 14th, okay? So June 14th is this week where it is happening in your 11th house, okay, and 2nd house. So 11th house is your house of groups, your long-term visions, and Uranus is in your 2nd house. So you could have money problems, okay? Especially if you want to start a project, start a business, you could have constraints with money. Or you have money and you want to invest, but there will be people asking you to slow down, to think about the consequences of investing so much in something, and you will have push and pull energy with regards to friends, group situations, your goals, and money. Okay, Aries, so that is the energy for this week and the end of the week of Feb 28th, but it will be the starting of the next week. But still, I'm telling you, but that I'll be doing it in the next week. June 20th, Jupiter is entering into Pisces, and that retrograde energy I'll focus for each sign specifically at that time. Okay, so this week it's going to be about Mars in Leo and Saturn and squaring Uranus. Okay, so that is the energy for this week. Okay, so this week we're going to do a tarot reading. I'm going to use the witch tarot for the main spread here. I'm going to do a 5-card spread for you, and there will be an overall energy that I'll pull out from the Lenormand, okay? And this week, I'm going to just take the chakras. I've removed the 7 chakras from the Energy Moon Oracle decks. And whatever chakra you can balance this week or you have to balance this week, I'll be focusing on it, okay? This is the last card I'll be pulling out, okay? So let's begin, Aries. Oh, I've not taken any clarifiers, okay? So if I'm in need of clarifiers, I'll pull a clarifier deck, okay? If not, we'll see. Or I'll clarify with the same deck also. We'll see how it goes, okay? So, it's always a test for you, for Aries. I'll always begin whatever I want to do. I'll do it only with Aries. So, Aries, let's see with potentially what's happening in your life right now. What is the energy, what you're dealing with, and how can you focus your spirituality, your everyday happenings. life is all about balancing practicality with spirituality, right? So every week you'll be having some kind of guidance from me to help you balance it out. Wow, you have the Aries woman for me. This is the other woman, or that is also called as a sexually fired up, a very, very daring. It's you, Aries, okay? Because this woman is all about taking charge, taking control, doing things as they want, being decisive, being impulsive, and also about being open to love, being daring, okay? So this week, Mars, your Martian energy is here, Aries. So your ruler entering into fifth house, this is the most potent time for you to attract persons that are very, very sexually compatible, or if you have a very high sex drive or libido also, you have to take care of it and you could meet someone. But for me, this is not the right woman, okay? So if you're ready for casual dating, casual something, just exploring your passion, your sexual side, this would be an awesome time for you, okay, this week. And this woman is also very, very bold, okay? So if you're hesitating to show your Martian energy, if you've been keeping it under the rugs, you can just lash it, just unleash it this time of the week, and you can explore it more, okay? You can be confident, to boost your confidence, to go for what you want in life, and all these will work out beautifully for you. So I'm going to keep this card here, okay? Let's pull a 5-card spread for you for what this energy is, okay? There's reversals in this deck because it's a weekly prediction. And also, we are seeing what you're actually dealing with, okay? So how your energy could be. This is potentially a weekly horoscope, so I'm going to do it with love, career, finances, family, everything, okay? Relationships, marriage, children, kids, anything can prop out of it, okay? It's just a weekly horoscope. And I have the Page of Swords here, okay? I'm using the card here, okay? So even though it's a little bit tough to shuffle, I'm just gonna pull the cards randomly for you. So it's not gonna be a big deal shuffling with a abnormal card, okay? So let's begin, Aries. I'm gonna do a 5-card spread. That is your main, what is your energy currently? What is your obstacle? What is your foundation, your past, your crowning energy, and your future, okay? So that is how I'm gonna do here. So let's begin. So what's the first energy? What is Aries currently dealing with? The Page of Swords came, but I'm not going to take it, okay? Because this card is going to jump out randomly for all signs. So I'm going to be a little bit careful and choose cards specifically for what I want to choose. Okay, let's begin. Here is Sun, Moon, Rising. What's your energy currently? What are you thinking? The Fool card. Wow, beautiful. So that's Aries for you. So this is all about taking a leap of faith, unleashing your power, your confidence, taking charge of your life, going for things that you always scared of, okay? So that is your current energy. What's the obstacle for you? Here is Sun, Moon, Rising, both male and female, okay? Wow, the Eight of Swords reversed. Beautiful. So you're coming out of fear, I think, okay? Finally, coming out of things, okay? Here, this woman is blindfolded. She has got swords all over it, but there is gaps between the swords. If she wants to move out, she can just take away the blindfold and come out of this sword. This is a self-imposed prison. That's what they call it. It's like mental block, fearing that if you take a leap of faith, there could be some kind of problems. You could have been stuck in this energy. With this in reverse, I think you need to understand that all these words are coming out of your mental thoughts are making you not go after something, not do something, okay? And you can definitely overcome it, okay? You can definitely overcome it. This is your obstacle here, okay? Let's see, what's the foundation for you? The foundation for you. Wow. The Knight of Cups reversed, okay? So the foundation for you is someone that is, maybe you're being a chaser, or they have been chasing you for a long time. Someone offered you a proposal, or they asked you out for a date or a casual meeting, or coming out, going out for a coffee or something like that, or they just tried to give a pleasant gesture for you, okay? And in this reverse, maybe you didn't accept it before. Your foundation, you're thinking about this offer, maybe this happened in the last week, it's in your foundation. So someone could have been chasing you, or someone could have potentially offered you something which you're now rethinking about, okay? So let's see. What's your past energy? The high priestess. Wow. So this is something hidden, using your intuition, listening to things, listening to your heart more than your mind, and also trying to understand where you sit with people or what you're thinking. Or if this see, in this deck there is a tarot reader. Okay, she's collecting information, she's trying to predict something, or she's trying to research something. Okay, so this high priestess is a witch. Okay, so she could be into collecting information in secret. So you could have been doing that in the past. Maybe you were in the mental prison, thinking too much about what you want to do, what you need to do, and maybe you're worried that right now you can do something that's maybe if you've been focused on what to do, you've been thinking, yeah, a lot of thinking, a lot of mental energy for you, Aries. So this is all about sleepless nights, overthinking things, being afraid of either chasing someone or afraid of chasing someone, or if you've been caught up in some energy. What did I do? Past, right? This is your crowning energy. Okay, so this is crowning for you. Okay, I'll be pulling it a little bit. Can you see the nine of swords here? Yeah, so this is the crowning energy. And then what's your outcome, your potential outcome? Wow, justice, high priestess and justice. Wow. Okay, so this feels like I have the six of swords in reverse. I'm not doing the back of the deck reading because I didn't split the deck, so this won't be considered. Okay, so this is the spread for you. Okay, there is knight of cups in reverse, eight of swords here. Okay, and there is a high priestess here. I'll keep this card here for you. Okay, and the nine of swords. So this is all about mental clarity. And if you think that you're ready to explore some new things, because this is your energy right now, Aries. So if you have been contemplating on using your intuition, if you've been secretly collecting information on whether you need to proceed into something or you need to work on something, or even if there was someone that was chasing you, giving you anxiety, mental trauma, or fear of a new life, a new pathway, going after a new person, whatever it is, okay? I think finally you understood that is the thing you have to do. And with the justice here, this could be either balancing out your scales, or by leaving this person, or not accepting this person, or trying to start new, because there is three majors here and two swords card and knight of cups in reverse. There's someone that is either trying to stop chasing people, stop being in this mental trauma, and move on with your life. Okay, this could be a moving on energy also. Finally just saying that no, I'm done with going after people who don't want me, or putting me in traumatic situations. I just want my mental peace. Justice is the Libra is all about peace. Okay, peace could be about having relationships that give you only positivity and not these anxiety or mental traumas. Okay, so I feel strongly this could be the energy for you this week. So I need to clarify. I'm gonna go with the hands and robots. We'll see. Hands and robots. There's reversals in this deck too. Okay, is it or is it not? No, there is no reversals in this deck. Okay, should I go with reversals or should I just clarify? Okay, I'm just going to clarify because it is just a past energy. So the full cards. Four of cups. Yeah, rejection. I think if someone was chasing you or you were chasing them. See, this could also mean someone that is with the wrong woman. Okay, if you have been chasing someone and they have been rejecting you, or you're getting rejected here, both Aries men and Aries women here. If there is strong rejection, it is like it is karmically asking you to stop this chase here. Maybe if you have been too much on your head trying to collect information, be secretive, or if they are not talking to you, you're trying to collect information about this person because you want this person to accept your proposal, accept you. I think you need to stop doing it, because maybe you feel like the chaser and this person could be the runner here. Okay, I'm not saying that there could be a runner, but we'll see. Eight of swords. This could also be someone that is plainly not interested in you. Okay, need not be a runner. the Eight of Swords here. So Eight of Swords is mental prison energy, where you're too much on the thoughts. King of Swords here, okay? So this could be you, Aries men, with Gemini, Libra or Aquarius in a chart. Libra is very strong here, okay? If not, if you're chasing a Gemini, Libra or an Aquarius man, okay? Aries women, okay? You're fired up, because air and fire goes very well together. You could have very, very sexual energy. You could be potentially attracted to this person. You want this person. You're trying to keep this person in your life, but maybe they don't want you. Maybe you offered them something, but they do not want this right now. Or you're stuck on this person because you want this person to accept you. Knight of Cups in reverse actually is the foundation. Ace of Cups. Yeah, this could be a new love, or this could be even reconciliation effects for me. I think this, with the Three of Cups here, two aces, wow, definitely someone wants to restart, reconcile. If you had a breakup, if you're trying to go away. Aries and Libra could also be dealing with each other, because Libra is the seventh house for Aries. So if you're dealing with a Libra man, tend to be little bit, both Four of Rods, wow. So this could be, I've been clarifying. So this is about proposal for marriage, or if this is your spouse, or if you're trying to get something started with this person, a commitment, even some reconciliation with your spouse or with your partner, okay? Especially if you're dealing with a Libra man, okay? Right now, maybe Three of Cups is, maybe there was some kind of arguments or some kind of potential breakup energy, I feel. Or this could be even loss, or if you're trying to come after a loss and reconcile with this person, especially if you're trying to build a life together, move in together, stay together, okay? And Aries, you had the fourth house energy and also fifth house energy. This could be a new love. If you're absolutely single, you could be attracting this. I don't think it's a singles reading, okay? Still, I'm telling you, if you are always worried about that, whether a new person, you will attract a new person, especially after you had some trauma, I think you could meet this fire air sign. But I think mostly this is someone you already knew and you want to start this person. This could be someone either proposed you marriage or wanted to marry you, or was willing to offer you a cup. It could be totally you also, Aries woman, okay? If you're chasing this man continuously, Libra is non-committal, okay? To be really frank, Libra is non-committal. It's very, very difficult to get a commitment that easily from a Libra man, okay? Libra woman can also take time to commit, okay? And Libra man is extremely, extremely flirtatious, extremely, they could be very, very in their mind about relationships. But the problem is, Libra men tend to take their time when they want to commit, because they don't want to settle down that easily. So if you are a fire sign woman trying to woo a Libra man, you need patience. And also, I don't think that you can easily marry this person, okay? Unless or until this person is above. The king is someone that is still in their explorative ages, okay? They could be around 25 to 30 years, okay? So this person, if he is younger than 25, you're not going to get a commitment from this person. Definitely not, okay? Because men tend to, especially Libra men and all, take time to settle down, okay? So let's see, what's the High Priestess here? What's the secret of them? I feel this is an absence. They do not want to talk. Yeah, Queen of Cups here. Okay, so you could be emotional here. Oh my God, Queen of Cups on the High Priestess. So that is a Pisces woman. Okay, let's see. The Lovers. Oh my God. Okay, I feel it's another woman here. Or this could also be someone that is secretive, emotionally tied up also. Because with the Lovers card here, this is a choice. For me, the Lovers High Priestess is not a good combo, because it is about a secret love, a secret, because this is in the past position, okay? This is in the past position. So if this person had an ex, maybe they are secretly still attached to this ex. And if you're trying to offer them a relationship, or you're offering them cup here, this person may have a choice, definitely. Libra, if it is a Libra, I'm telling you, there is another woman. If it is an Aquarius or a Gemini man, this Queen of Cups is a Pisces, that that if you are an Aries man, if you have two choices, okay, especially if you have air in your chart, if you're chasing, because Knight of Cups energy is something, someone that is chasing, okay. I'm gonna say it's not like someone, they literally go after, run after. It's like they just toss a coin, okay, and they say like, if she agrees, okay, let's date for some time. If this woman gives me some signals, this person is playing the field, okay. I think this person is playing the field, and especially the Justice and the Nine of Swords is maybe you found out this person had another party in your life, or you were the third party. I don't know, because the Ace and the Four of Rods seems to be a new love here. Okay, let's clarify the Nine of Swords, why that is in your crowning energy here. Maybe you don't know which is the right woman for you, Aries man, Five of Rods. Yeah, definitely you don't know. Oh God, Aries woman, if you are in competition with another female, okay, especially a Pisces, you know that this person is in your man's life, or this person is also equally competing for you. See, Aries, Leo and Sagittarius are fiery, and they tend to be very competitive than the Pisces or Scorpio could be competitive, Pisces or Cancer woman, okay. Cancerian and Pisces women tend to be really, really homebodies. They work on their own situations, and they are very, very intuitive also, so they do not want to, they don't go and compete in practical ways, or in it's like, okay, who are you talking to, what are you doing, why are you doing this, all these stuffs these women don't ask. They secretly listen to their intuition. They know what is happening. They found out maybe they have a choice, maybe they are the third party, or they have a choice to be made, and maybe this person is trying to keep their emotions close to their chest. They are not talking, okay. Maybe they are trying to see where this person goes, because the Eight of Swords could also mean that something is happening behind the scenes. So if this person knows that this person is trying to put themselves in a third party situation and trying to play the field, trying to woo different women, this person knows, okay. And if you are an Aries woman with water in your chart, this could be you, okay, but I highly doubt it, but still we'll see it. The Justice card, why is the Justice here? These are all in the past, okay, so it's not prediction, these are all in the past. The Fool card, yeah, I think if you are an Aries man or an Aries woman, okay, which generally, I'm gonna put it in two ways, okay. If you had a proposal, if you wanted to marry, or if you were in a commitment, I don't think it's a committed, it just could be someone that wanted commitment. I don't think it's a commitment, it's a wanted, someone wanted commitment, someone wanted to settle down, someone wanted to marry, especially if it is a Libra or a Gemini, Aquarius man. Okay, they have another party here, okay. Maybe you found out, maybe you try to woo this person sexually, or even seduce this person by giving your by trying to give you offer your cup, and you have been the chaser. I feel a chaser energy here. If you have been the chaser, I'm sorry to tell you, there is another person here, and they have a choice to make. And a man, Libra man, could be flirting for a long time, okay. So they are not going to settle down that easily. If it is a Fool card, it means that you need to restart your life with two fools here. I think in the past also there is a fool energy. Maybe you felt like a fool to keep chasing this person. Maybe you felt like that this person is always trying to put you in competition, and you tried to back out this person, or give your sincere proposals or sincere commitment efforts here, but still you did not win, because this is a competition. Maybe you wanted to win, you wanted to be the chosen person, and you're giving up finally. With the Fool here twice, I think you know the Justice here, things needs to be in balance. And if this, there is a choice here, this could be even Gemini here, okay. So Gemini and Libra is strong here than Aquarius, okay. So if you are dealing with a Gemini or an Libra man, and you know that is a potential competition here, and you know there are people that is trying to get this person's attention, or this person is not being true to you, you need to leave this relationship out, okay. This relationship or this bond where you're dealing with a man, and especially if you are a Aries with Libra, Gemini in your chart, okay, and if you have, wow, I'm sorry. If you are a Gemini or a Libra man with Aries in your chart, I think you need to know, are you being too much on your head with choosing whether the Pisces woman or the Aries woman here, okay? And I don't think, maybe you are trying to figure out who is the right marital person for you, but I don't think, I'm just going to check out, why is the Five of Rods here? What is the competition about? The Nine of Swords here. The Tower, okay. could be something shocking. Maybe you found out that this person had a third party, or they were in a third party hierophant. Oh my goodness. Hierophant here. Okay, clarify the four of rods here. Clarify the four of rods. Ten of pentacles. Okay, this is a marriage. Okay, so the first is absolutely chasing energy. Okay, second is if you are single, if you are flirtatious and you found out there is another person. If you are a married Aries or a married Aries man, whatever it is, okay, there is a marriage in place and there is a commitment, but the problem is maybe someone else stepped out of the marriage with another woman here. There is a secret woman. They have a choice to be made. Maybe you're trying to save your marriage. You're trying to save your relationship with this person by offering them, or you tried to pull this energy together, but you found out this person was cheating on you or had another person here. And finally, it's time to move on. It's like the energy is moving on, okay? You found out the truth. The truth came out to light and you're finally done with the situation here, okay? Aries, okay, we'll see what chakra you need to focus on. Second chakra, okay. Second chakra is your sexual chakra, okay? It's all about your sexual energy. So if you have been trying to keep a person, or if you have been too much like focused on your sexuality to attract men, to keep men, and also about wooing men by seducing, and you have been too physical, too out there with your sexuality, I think with the women here, with the second chakra here, with the competition here. And because I told you, only fire signs can be competitive, and they usually sleep with people to keep them together, or to check that they are in a commitment, okay? But water signs are not like that, okay? They'll be intuitive, they'll be calm, and they'll be doing everything in secret. So maybe the mystery attracts this person. Maybe you putting in out too much of yourself, your body, your sexual energy could have been rippling this person out. Maybe they like the mystery of this woman, okay? I don't know. If you are a water sign, maybe try to be a little bit mysterious and keep control and check over your second chakra and balance it out. Okay, Aries, okay? I hope this reading resonated with you. Thank you.